Welcome back to Norwich Meadows Farm, Mr. Peter. How are you today?
I'm glad I got here.
Good. So, yeah, you suggested a very important topic that I kind of take for granted. So how do you prepare for winter? Well, I'll give you the answer to that is that's when I can actually eat a lot more of my produce than I do in the summer when I'm really busy. So we do various things to preserve our own produce for winter. So for example, one of my favorite dishes is fava beans. And we take young, very young fava beans and we cut them up into small 1.5-2 inch pieces and we saute it lightly in olive oil to kill out the enzymes. And then we take those and we put them in a 2.5-pound bag and we throw them in the freezer. In the winter, we cook them over lamb and serve them over rice, one of my favorite meals. The other thing you can do is, you know, any of your vegetables can be frozen and or canned. Canned, obviously, is a much more involved process. So for us, when we don't have a lot of time, you can take tomatoes, throw them in a bag and put them in the freezer. And then in the wintertime, you take those tomatoes out. For anybody who's tried to skin tomatoes when they're fresh, they will appreciate frozen tomatoes because those skins come off much, much easier. And then you make a fresh spaghetti sauce and or a tomato soup from your delicious tomatoes of the summer. We also take our green beans, boil them in water for literally 10 seconds until they turn color, again to kill off the enzymes, and then put them in bags and throw them in the freezer the same way. If you want to get real industrious, you can actually learn how to can, and then therefore you don't need refrigeration. But that's a discussion that's a lot longer. You know, we can't really talk about how you do that right here and now.
What are the enzymes you're talking about?
The enzymes that are in fruits and vegetables, if they are left active, it basically will change the flavor or make it bad. So that's the blanching process. The blanching process stops those enzymes so that when you throw it in the fridge, you know, the bean that you put in the freezer is pretty much the same taste as the bean you take out 3 or 4 months later. So we do a lot of that. In fact, we have about, in our garage, we have 3 to 4 upright freezers, and they're full of vegetables from the summertime.
Wow. So what do you do with, like, leafy green stuff?
We don't. You can do the same thing to leafy greens. We do not preserve leafy greens for the wintertime, but there are plenty of people who do that. So we mostly preserve things like okra, squashes, beans, tomatoes. We also freeze our ginger and then take it out and use it over the winter. But you can do it with any vegetable. You know, we just do what we prefer. And in the winter, we have a lot of leafy greens that we harvest out of our high tunnels anyway, so we don't really need to preserve them.
It's true. I've noticed over the last couple of years, you've had leafy greens later and early.
Yep.
So I really appreciate it.
Yep. And then a lot of other things are store. You can take potatoes, put them in a 5-gallon bucket in sand, and put them in a place where it's 50 degrees or a little warmer than that, and they will stay okay. And then you got your onions and your garlic and all of that. That can actually store outside of a refrigerator. So there are vegetables that can store without the use of refrigeration. So we do that every week. We do some of it. Haifa at home will preserve something, and we're filling up our freezers for the winter.
I better get to it. I haven't been doing it.
You better get a freezer, Peter.
I have a freezer. I put my compost in it, but I'm gonna start flash
freezing.
Flash, yeah. Well, flash boiling and then freezing.
Okay, yeah, because flash freezing is a expensive proposition. You need a special freezer.
All right. Well, all right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Where are we?
We are at Union Square, Friday. We'll be here tomorrow, and we'll be at Tompkins Sunday and back here on Monday.
Okay.
Thank goodness.
Good night.
Life isn't the same without you.
Look
how healthy I am.
I know.
I'm 75. They feed me. Got any eggs?
So.
Was Haifa in there somewhere?
So what are you cooking tonight?
Oh, we make soup every week. So we took all the greens, onions, ginger, tomatoes, and some whatever they have, we try to get this thing. And we love this place, and the food, vegetables are fresh, no comparison. The recipe is we put everything together with some cumin, ginger, turmeric, garlic, and we throw everything. We add some desi ghee, which is like a form of butter, and that's it. Salt and pepper, nothing fancy.
What do you like cooking?
Soup. That's my favorite. And I like their fresh greens. And I make a green soup. We call it saag, which is basically a green leafy soup.
Wow! I love your shoes.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah.